Good morning, Your Excellencies. Dear Dr. Takeshi, Region Director from the Wepro Region, Dr. Mowetu, the Region Director of the Afro Region, thank you for joining us for the briefing today. I would like to begin in sending our thoughts and best wishes to the people, family, businesses who are working together to manage and adapt to the COVID-19 in their communities, and in particular those in your countries and further afield who are being directly impacted by the virus. I also want to take a moment to personally and on behalf of the European Regional Office of the World Health Organization express our thanks and gratitude to those on the front line, our heroes, the health workforce, working day and night to serve our communities. There are three main messages I want to convey to you today. Firstly, we can beat the virus only through solidarity. The situation is still worsening and we need to stand together to tackle it. As of this morning, there are 207,996 cases reported in 238 countries, states and territories globally. The trend has now reversed, with China recording less than 45% of the global cases. 8,659 people have unfortunately lost their lives to COVID-19 so far. The European region is the epicenter of the pandemic today, representing over 40% of global cases. COVID-19 is a test of solidarity and psychological resilience that we simply cannot afford to fail. It is crucial that we all abide by the principles of international cooperation, transparency and solidarity. It is important we do this together, learn from each other and harmonize our efforts. It is up to us to make this happen. Here I would like to ask your governance to seriously consider to lift export bans on personal protective equipment and also for those countries which has closed their borders to exempt the WHO teams that the countries are being requesting to us to go to your countries to support you. Also, as you see, with three region directors present today, we in WHO stand in solidarity. Second main message is we should assure that health is kept at the top of the agenda. Investment in the health systems today is investments in the national security today and tomorrow. The course of history has changed in 12 weeks and we still do not know where this will end. As of this morning, there were 85,493 cases reported in the WHO European region, with the last 24 hours more than 11,000 new cases. Four countries, Italy, Spain, France and Germany, account for over 77% of all European cases, with a rising curve. The lives of millions of people in our region are undergoing radical change. This is quite simply a new reality. The role of public health services is understood. The value of health workers is appreciated. And a lot of appreciation to the ministers of health who are the center of this epic battle. Our health systems and services are valued like never before. When the vulnerability and frailty of our way of living is appreciated, health is at the top of the agenda. Your Excellencies, Honourable Ambassadors and Delegates, I applaud all of your governments, our member states, for the contribution of your human and financial resources, your energy and your goodwill for these global efforts. It is time to leave no one behind nor on the sidelines. I would like to ask your governments to continue to reach out to us to assist however you can with the preparedness and response efforts. The WHO, the United Nations Foundation and partners have launched a first of its kind COVID-19 Solidarity Response Funds that finances support to the most needed and vulnerable and support the WHO strategic preparedness and response plans. Here in the European region, the COVID-19 response plan is benefiting from the input and advocacy of Dr. David Nabarro, who has been appointed by Dr. Tedros as a WHO Special Envoy for Europe to assist us for the COVID-19 preparedness and response. I am sincerely grateful for his support. Your governments can be assured that the resources we receive to raise both human and financially are being prioritized in those countries where the needs and risks are higher and where health systems' capacities are lower. I guarantee I will do everything to ensure the contributions are used efficiently and effectively. My third message is that addressing COVID-19 is an all of government and all of society responsibility. On the 11th of March, the WHO Director General announced the first pandemic of coronavirus in history. This was based on the 13-fold increase in cases in the previous 2 weeks and the number of affected countries across the globe. This was our call to action to every country to take its boldest action to fight the new virus, to triple the effort in an all-of-society and all-of-government action. I would like to ask your governments to coordinate and integrate their responses across all sectors, including a lot of effort and attention to the social sector to protect the elderly. The community engagement is critical. I ask your governments to invest resources, time and effort into risk communication and community engaging that puts listening on an equal footing as speaking. Dear Excellencies, there are three priorities. I will focus particularly on the first because it is so important. One, we should apply rapid, robust and rigorous containment and suppression of COVID-19 outbreaks as they start. We must act quickly because the public health task and socio-economic consequences are so much harder even if we delay by 1 day or 2 days. But we must maintain the focus on containment and suppression even when community transmission is well established. We have seen from Southeast Asia experience that if we focus on this and do it well, we'll contain our COVID-19 outbreaks and reduce the need for damaging shutdowns that cause so much misery for our people. Two, to prepare and be ready. Every person, every health worker, every health facility must be ready to protect and care. Hospital preparedness and capacity is crucial. Third, every country through community mobilization must consider and implement social distancing. Social distancing is not social isolation. Social distancing is solidarity. Many of our countries in Europe are now acting to flatten the epidemic curve and suppress the COVID-19 outbreaks. As you will hear from the Western Pacific, from the African region, and from Denmark shortly, different containment and mitigation strategies are being applied so that fewer new cases arise over a longer period. We at the WHO Region Office for Europe are working with you 24/7 to control this pandemic. We have provided expert support with 40 in-country missions over the past month, and we are working with partners, particularly the European Commission and emergency medical teams, to scale up capacity to respond. In closing, I want to repeat my three take-home messages to the governments. One, please connect with each other and coordinate your responses and make sure that measures introduced by one nation help and do not hamper the response in another country. Two, please continue supporting the response with resources and acting in solidarity, including all and leaving no one behind, assuring the most vulnerable are supported. Three, please encourage communities and sectors of your society to be engaged and promote an all-of-government and society response. I thank you for your attention, your commitment, and all your efforts.